All right, spiritual family. So, I am here today to do a video. And some fuckery just came across my attention. Somebody sent this to me. I'm going to hold this up. I hope y'all can hear this. But somebody sent this to me on Instagram, and I'll just let it play. Oh, wait a minute. It's not.
This guy's admitting to the fact that government.
Oh, wait a minute. Let me just make sure. I might have to. Okay. Let me just make sure.
Black people, this is just for you, because this guy's admitting to the fact that governments are trying to exterminate you.
Where does any synthetic molecule serve the living?
They don't.
Right.
I mean, none.
And am I right in suggesting that a medicine, by definition, is something which contains synthetic molecules, something that is registered, patented, and put into the market as a medicine?
Absolutely.
Right. So what I'm learning from you, Dr. Young, is that a quadrillion-dollar enterprise is at work amongst us, decimating, culling the human family.
Intentionally.
Intentionally, using synthetic molecules, which by design are cancer, AIDS, all of the bogeymen you could dream up.
Yeah, so for the purpose of sterilization and population control, there's too many people on the planet we need to get rid of. In the words of Bill Gates, at least 3 billion people need to die. So we'll just start off in Africa. We'll start doing our research there, and we'll eliminate most of the Africans because they're deplorable. They're worthless. They're not part of this world economy. So they have their rights taken away, and they're suppressed, and they're experimented.
And the multilateral agencies and the health and regulatory so-called authorities and agencies appear in the main to have become weaponized, and appear, I again use the word appear advisedly, we're not casting judgments here, we're taking depositions, listening to expert testimonies, appear to be weaponized and appear to be working in collusion against the living men and women of the soil. Is that a fair statement?
It is. It's not a bacterial war. It's a systemic poisoning war, and they're using chemical warfare against all of us.
Okay, so on that note, I will just stop right there. So, and no need to get emotional, because this is the fuckery that happens on planet Earth. And this has been going on, you know, for a while. You know. Let me just light an incense. Now, this is to show you the outright evil of, you know, certain members of humanity. And don't get it twisted. It ain't only the white folks. It's the black folks too. Because you got, you know, blacks on the continent that, you know, have done similar to their own people. When you look at the Rwandan massacre, you look at what's going on in Sudan, you know, what's taking place on various parts of the continent, you know, and you know, you will always, well, not always, but there has always been like maybe 3% or 5% ruling over 95%, and you know, everything has been used, you know, religion, germ warfare, spiritual warfare, you know, all kinds of warfare against the populace. Well, now that we are awakened, because now we see shit like this. Once upon a time, we wouldn't know about stuff like this. It would just be happening, and people just be like dropping dead and, you know, coming up with terminal illness, and we don't know, You know, but now we're in the age of exposure. And this is the age of, you know, enlightenment. This is the age of awakening. And this is the age of where, you know, secret knowledge are being made known. Now, this is where we come in. Okay? Let me take some of my Now, let me see. I'm going to start this. We are in the age of ear. Now that we know this, we have the power to counteract some of this using, not even some, but all of it. But it depends on the power that you are working with spiritually. And I'm just going to say and keep it real and honest, you know, because there's not a lot of ethical, honest spiritualists in the spiritual community. There's a lot of deceptive, dishonest, you know, outright evil and wicked spiritual practitioners. And I mean, this exists in every segment of society, religious, educational, you know, medical, whatever. That's just humanity. And this is where you come in, because now that we're in the age of Aquarius, which is the age of ear, this is the age of using the power of ear. You know, you hear life and death is in the power of the tongue. And so that's real. That's real. And so when you hear stuff like this, what you are to do is, you know, the people who plan this, what they are planning against humanity will be the very thing that destroys them and their entire lineage. See, Bill Gates can say all of this shit, but he don't know, bitch, you can go down in a fiery plane crash in the mountains. Your highfalutin plane can crash in the mountains and explode in a fiery implosion. Okay? Now, I'm just going to read something here about the ear. Here and now, I, Priestess Aset Ra Amen, and you can put your own name in it, invoke the elemental force of ear. I, Priestess Aset Ra Amen, call to the summer breeze, to the breeze and the roaring wind, to the echoing wind and song that is ever dancing, that is ever moving. You, elemental force of ear, that teaches lessons of the invisible. You that topple trees. I invoke you. I call you forth. I call you here to infuse my intention with your swirling gifts, with your swirling power. I, Priestess Aset Ra Amen, invoke the power of wind, the power of the spirit of the wind to carry my will, my intentions, my manifestations, my heka on your back, and carry and raise my purpose into the sky and to bring it forth on those who I declare to invoke my words of retribution and power upon. Great primordial power of ear. mother of Ear. I, priestess Aset Ra Amen, invoke your divine power, your divine essence, your divine energy. In the name of the primordial mothers, Ashe. Can you see this incense lit? You see the ear? This is ear. And you can speak your desires into it. Now, let me get something here. Words of power, or warit hekau, are the words and phrases spoken and written that invoke and control the power of Heka magic. The Kemetic people, for the Kemetic people, written language was powerful and potentially as dangerous as the spoken word. In fact, it's documented that the hieroglyphics of dangerous animals like the crocodile were often purposely altered to diminish their power, to prevent them from magically coming to life. Okay? Now, Aset, with her words of power, can stop the sun in her tracks, control the weather, heal the sick, resurrect the dead. Okay? Called cleverer than a million gods and more devious than a million men, Aset used her ingenuity for the benefit of others, including her son Heru, the rightful pharaoh of Kemet. Now, Aset is also my spiritual mother, because it was she years ago, I want to say probably about 25 years ago, something like that, when I was meditating in deep transcendental meditation. And she came to me and she pointed her finger in my forehead, in my third eye, and she said, your name is Aset Ra Amen. And I was like, wow, okay. Because I was, you know, trying to invoke my spiritual name. I wanted to get my spiritual name, because each of us has a spiritual name, but it's up to you to get it. For some people, I have gotten it when I've done readings for them, you know, and I have tapped in, have gotten their spiritual names. It doesn't happen for everybody. You know, I'm sure if I, you know, was to go deeper and further, I could get it. But, you know, a reading takes, it's a certain amount of time, from a half an hour to an hour, depending on the reading, and you might not get it then, but you have the power to go and get your spiritual name from the spiritual realm. You know what I'm saying? Especially when you're on the spiritual path, you do have a spiritual name. And so, you know, I was given mine by Aset, you know, but she gave me Aset. You know, and so now that we are in the age of Ear, which is the age of Aquarius, we have the power. We are no longer powerless against the so-called powers that be. And I don't call these despots lunatic, psychopaths, deranged, devils, you know, powers that be, because to me, real powers that be, and I've often said, is a meteorite slamming into this bitch. You know, hurricanes, tornadoes, tsunami, earthquake, those are powers that be. And right now we're in a time where, you know, the mother, the primordial mother, is really tired of humanity and the fuckery that they have been doing, because, you know, I tap in quite often and I received downloads, just like I had received a download that the continent of Africa is going to be split in half. Now, this isn't going to happen in our lifetime. And I remember when I did that video, I was called all kind of crazy, bipolar, whatever. But scientists have now confirmed that the continent of Africa is splitting in half. And the reason that's happening is because of all the stuff that have happened on the continent. And to be honest, Mother is just tired. Just like I received another download, if those assholes in Israel don't get it together and keep fighting and this and that, you know, it's just going to be a giant earthquake that's going to destroy all of Israel, taking the whole country, you know, like the earth literally opens up. And, you know, that's what's going to have to happen. The same thing will happen like in, you know, in different parts of the world like Russia, China. Basically, we as a species have got to get it together. The word from the primordial mother is that she is pretty much tired of us on this planet, that we have had enough time to elevate. Because one of the things, you know, I heard, like, we should have evolved from wars by now. The true definition of evolution is humanity evolving from those lower base, negative, destructive frequencies and evolving to a higher frequency of love, compassion, and empathy for our fellow woman, man, you know, human. And it doesn't mean that we are going to be perfect. Actually, we are perfect, but we're human. So it doesn't mean that we're, you know, always going to be like, hum-de-la-lam-lam-lam. No. But the reality is we should have evolved beyond those negative tendencies. I mean, goddamn, we've been waging wars on this planet for centuries. At what point did these motherfuckers learn the fine art of go sit your ass down on planet Earth and learn to get along with your fellow, you know, brethren, you know? Let me see, is this recording? I hope it's recording, you know. Hold on, I'm just going to scream for Hathor. Let me see, 8. I just want to make sure because I did this and, you know, this is Hathor's. I just make the videos and she just uploads them. So I'm looking at 8 to see, you know. Let me see if it hits the 9, you know, and make sure that I'm recording. Okay, I'm just going to keep going. Okay. And so basically, okay, runs 9. Basically, the mother, planet Earth, Mother Earth, is a living, breathing entity. And, you know, the way how it was revealed to me, because there was a while back when I was meditating and I saw the primordial mother, Mother Earth, she was screaming. She was just so angry at, you know, the fuckery going on here on the planet. And when you think of it as a mother trying to rest peacefully. And the children are just tearing up the house and, you know, throwing stuff down and just banging and blowing up and just, you know, just doing all manners of disturbance. And so she is literally tired. And I don't have anything against Caucasians because, like I said, this ain't about Caucasians, even though this guy clearly was Caucasian talking about the fuckery that Caucasians are doing. But Nubians also do the same thing. But Caucasians, for the most part, in about 200, 300 years, there won't be any of them left on the planet. They are literally going to have to breed with us to stay on this planet because they are the youngest species that was created with the least amount of melanin. And at some point, they just will not be on the planet anymore. Okay? And the only way for them to survive is to you know, breed with us to continue on this planet. And that's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we as a species have got to come together in harmony, because the planet herself is tired of the continued disrespect, not only of the planet, but of the resources, the people and stuff. And so, you know, this has to come to an end. And so now that we are in the age of ear, we are to use the energies of ear, okay? And I'm just gonna, let me just put something here. A couple of my books that I use. Tree of Life Meditation System by Ra Unefermen. You know, which is an excellent book. And this is dealing with the Kabbalah system, you know. Let me see. Saturn, Mars and Mercury. Mercury is Hod. And this is where we're at now, the Mercurian energy of ear. This is on the left-hand path of the Tree of Life, which is Saturn, Mars, and Mercury. And my path is the 18th path between Saturn and Mars, okay? Which is funny, because in my natal chart, my Saturn is in Aries, you know? So, you know, it's just perfect. And so, you know, we are now in the energy of ear, because Aquarius, the age of Aquarius, is ruled by ear. And so when you look, we are supposed to be working with the power of ear, the power of Heka, okay? And this is the power of, you know, the spoken word and even the written word. That when we see stuff like this, we are to turn it back on those people, that which you desire to use against humanity will be the very thing that destroys you and, quite frankly, your entire lineage. None of you need to be on the planet. And you can write this and you can burn it. You know, you can speak it. Because we are past the energies of doing ritualistic magic. There was a time when we did ceremonial magic, and this was, you know, having on the cloak, you know, and doing all of this magic. And then there's ritualistic magic where, you know, sacrificing goats and chickens, and that's some patriarchal shit. We don't need to, that's those times have passed, even though people are still doing it. And you got some parts on the continent and some parts in the world where people are actually still sacrificing children, babies, to their gods. And when you see these sacrificial things being done of goats and chickens, they're really being done to lower level entities, because people made pacts. This is what was revealed to me. This is why I don't partake in those things. That people made pacts with lower level entities when they, you know, sold their people into slavery and did all kinds of shit. And so, you know, they're sacrificing these animals to these beings, these lower level entities, because there are no high vibrating entity that needs the blood of an animal. Let me say it louder for the ones in the back. There are no high vibrating entities, energies that require the blood of an animal. You are the altar. You are the offering. The offering is your words. When you get a glass of water, you know what I'm saying? Let me pause this for a minute. I'll be back. All right, so I am back. So, let me Now, back to the lecture at hand. The power of words is your essence. You are the power. And this is why so much was done to people in religion, and why so much is still being done to keep you in a state of fear, keep you in a state of anxiety, depression, but more so fear. And you are being assaulted from all end. You are being assaulted from every angle. Unplug this right here. You are assaulted from every angle. The music, the news. You don't need to watch the news. It's all, most of it is manufactured. And yes, there's stuff going on in the world. You know, your local news, fine. But, you know, a lot of this stuff is done to keep you in fear. Because I know people that, and I used to watch the news all the time. And I'd be clutching my pearls, you know, like, oh, you know. And then it was like, why do you get up and watch this shit and it puts you into such a state of fear and depression and anger and rage? And that's what it's meant to do, to lower your vibrations. It's like when music, when we had, you know, when we had music that was uplifting and, you know, inspiring. And then that went out and gangster rap came in. And if you listen to the music nowadays, it's all to lower your vibration. Because it's all about drug use and murder and killing and robbery. And then I call the female, you know, the unsexy Reds and others like her, the whole rap, you know, the whole rap. Because it's all about this degeneracy, this, you know, people dressing naked and, you know, just rapping about, you know, all kinds of fuckery, you know. And this don't mean that we're perfect, but you have to look at, these people are paid by an industry to destroy the minds of the youth. They willingly sign up to get money to continue the degeneracy. Because think of the little young impressionable girls listening to these whole raps and seeing these female rappers, you know, dressing naked and having their titties and their ass out and just rapping about their body parts and this and that, you know what I'm saying? I mean, this is all by design. Because when you are vibrating on that frequency, you can't vibrate at a frequency that's high, that, you know, that you can get messages from the source. It keeps you at a lower, you know, state of where, you know, your mind is just, you know, corrupted. And, you know, it serves a purpose of destruction. And so, you know, this is what it is. And the music for the young guys, a lot of the, you know, you listen to a lot of the male rappers, it's the same thing. And it's just, it's an assault. It's an assault on the minds of the youth and whoever partakes in it. Because they, the 3-5%, whatever, that rules over the 97 and the 95%, know that you are awakening. And know that this is the age of spiritual enlightenment. And the 144,000 that are awake, and we are awakened, but we're all over the place. You know, when we start vibrating on the same frequency, it's a wrap. And they know this because their time is at hand. Their time is at hand. And their time is finished. And there will come a time when there will be the collective consciousness will come into love, peace, joy. I probably won't see it in my lifetime. You know, I don't know if it'll come in the next lifetime or maybe the third lifetime, you know, but it's coming. It's going to come because this was foretold, like a one world order, one world government or something where everyone has a say and the resources are evenly distributed, the eradication of hunger, poverty, homelessness, and all this other stuff. And this is what they are fighting so hard, you know, to destroy as many as they can, to corrupt your minds. And so now that we know, you know, this is where we have got to be working with the energies of ear. And so, you know, the pentacles of Mercury. And this is where, let's see, I like this one. The second pentacle of Mercury that grants wishes. And we're not doing anything that's contrary to the, oh, the third pentacle. Oh, yes. The third pentacle of Mercury influences the written word, tending to make one eloquent in letters, papers, or any writings. And a fourth one that assists in acquiring spiritual knowledge and understanding of all things, spiritual things, and penetrates hidden thoughts. The pentacles of Mercury, you know, I like the second. Let's see, and a third, and a fourth, that penetrates the etheric realm. You know what I'm saying? And when you use like the third pentacle of Mercury and you invoke the power of Aset, you invoke the power of Mercury, the power of thought. And you now, the words that you write, and you also invoke the ancient spirit of the Nomos. These are the ancient spirits of our ancestral water deities. And invoke the ancient spirits of the wind. And you put it and you write it on paper, whatsoever you write. And you speak it into the ether. The wind carries it. And if you light it and you burn it and you allow the ashes to go into the ether, it goes into the ether. Okay? And also because we are in, you know, the age of Aquarius, who's also ruled by Saturn. Just one second. We can use any of the, the seventh pentacle of Saturn. Let's see. First pentacle, strike terror upon the spirits and cause others to submit to the possessor's will. The second one, of great value when meeting with adversaries in business. The third one, good for protection against plots made by others and defense against wicked or evil spirits. And I like the third pentacle because this is the one that I tell everybody that they can, you know, they can work with, being that we're in the age of Aquarius. Now, the fourth is like those who wish to impose their will upon others. And the fifth protects and guards the home. And the sixth, you know, pronounce the enemy's name. And, you know, set a spirit to, you know, to pronounce the enemy's name and repeat, set thou a wicked one to be a ruler over him, and let Satan, you know, stand at his right hand to cause him to be possessed by, you know, and that one can also, let's see, you have one of them too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I think the seventh one, I like the seventh one, that the talisman is reputed to make others tremble before the words of the wearer, you know. And it depends on you and what you would like, you know, for the neophyte, you know what I'm saying? Let's see, 1, 2. Good for protection. I would use the third pentacle of Saturn. That's good for protection against any plots that's made by others. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And so with that, you know, the third pentacle of Mercury, that is used to influence the written word and also your words of power. When it says life and death is in the power of the tongue, that shit is real, okay? And so on that note, I am also going to, you know, talk about some crystals that's associated with the ear type energy. The first one, of course, is clear quartz. You know, clear quartz is the master crystal, you know, that can be used for any purposes, but it's one of the ear type energy. And this is a big ass, you know, let me see, a big ass pendant that I got off of Epsy. And I also wear, you know, with others, and you know, with others, these are all the Solomon keys that I work with, you know, when I'm ready to do my Shamalama Ding Dong. And let's see, this is also a clear quartz that I wear around my neck with, you know, my Numite, my, you know, black tourmaline, my black obsidian, you know, because you got to stay strapped out in these spiritual streets. Last week I was doing a reading for a woman, and she was mounted by a spirit. Let me take a sip of this shit. I was doing a reading for a woman, and she got mounted by a spirit, and she just started speaking in another language, and just, you know, and this entity that came upon her just possessed her, mounted her. And I was like, oh shit. So I went and I got my sistrum and I started shaking it. And I commanded the spirit, you know what I'm saying, to get the fuck on. Leave this lady alone. You know, you will leave this woman. You will get away from her. And the spirit left and she came back to herself, because like I said, the sistrum was used in ancient Kemet to repel negative spirits. And it was also used to call the gods and the goddesses. Because see, entities, you know, don't like sistrum, tambourines. You know what I'm saying? Because what it does, it's like having jars in pennies in a jar that shakes up. It does something to their frequency. And they just can't stand it. So they got it. Move. Don't, I'm doing a video, so you can't walk through here with that. Leave that right there, and when you're done, when I'm done, you can, yeah, take that down, okay? Thank you very much. Now, Yes, so, you know, I, you know, did my little Shamalama Ding Dong with my sister, and the spirit left her, you know, the entity that had mounted her, you know. And so this is what we do. And this is why we stay strapped out in the spiritual street, because even, you know, wearing things like blue sapphire, yellow sapphire, you know, they have spiritual protection and different spiritual, you know, energies, okay? And so, you know, with that being said, like even a glass of water, when you speak into the water, and I, Priestess Aset Ra, amen. You know, I call forth the spirit of water and I invoke the ancient, my ancient ancestral primordial mothers. I invoke the ancient spirit of Aset, the energy of Aset, Aset, and I ask for her divine power, her divine wisdom, her divine guidance, her divine knowledge, her divine protection. And I speak that which I desire will now be made manifest. And you throw it up in the air, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Whatever. And this is how it's done now. We are now awakened that we can counteract all this stuff that's being done. And this is why I said, you know, for spiritualists, we ain't got to go out and protest. We ain't got to get involved in the fuckery. You know, we can just, we have the power and we speak. No weapons formed against my people shall prosper. And those outside the race and the devils inside the race, the devils inside and outside, that form weapons, that which they do must be the very weapons that destroy them and their lineage. And don't get it twisted. There will be stuff done on this earth, you know, to kill people and stuff. That's always been something. But no, that there is an afterlife, and as in life, so in death. You are not going to escape what you do. What was shown to me, there isn't a hell with a guy with a pitchfork. No, but what you cause on this planet, when you get to that side, you will be made to see that which you have done. And you will have to relive that frequency. You will be made to feel what you have done times like a million or a thousand. And that is the worst thing, because you can't go anywhere. You can't do anything. You have to reap what you sow. And if you are ever incarnated, you will be reborn severely disabled, severely. You'll fuck around and be reborn blind, deaf, and dumb, homeless, you know, something where you get abused, you know, something. You know what I'm saying? You will not escape that which you have done. And this is what it is. And this is why we now, there's a reason why things like this are being made known. Because once upon a time, you know, I wouldn't have known about this. Y'all wouldn't have known about this. This was been, you know, people plotting on humanity, on whatever segment of humanity. But now that we're in the age of a spiritual enlightenment and awakening, and there's a reason why we're coming across such knowledge, so now you have your part. And this is where your sacred Heka comes in. This is where power of the word, that no weapons formed against us, and that those who form these weapons must reap that which they desire to sow against humanity, them and their lineage. Not just them, fuck that. I want their lineage off this planet too. You know what I'm saying? And even after you leave this planet, you must experience it also in the afterlife. You know what I'm saying? Because this is what it is. And so now you have the ability to use your words. And this is where, you know, when you look in your natal chart, you see, where's your Mercury? Is your Mercury in fire, water, earth, air? You know what I'm saying? And this, the power, life and death is in the power of the tongue. Listen, that is real. I have spoken things that have manifested on the physical realm. I remember being bullied in high school, you know, because I was just, you know, just came from Jamaica, had a funny accent, dressed funny, and I used to have a bully that terrorized me. He terrorized me. Oh my goddess, he made my life a living hell. And I remember one time I was so angry. And I was just like, I wish somebody would fucking kill him. I want him dead. 2 weeks later, he ran upon somebody he messed with and they shot him in the head and killed him. There you go. Life and death is in the power of the tongue. Because there was so much energy behind what I spoke. Like Jamaican say, if you have vocative behind what you speak, you got to have power. Because what this is about your frequency, your power. You understand? And like I said, like movies like Avatars, you know, cartoons like Avatars and like X-Men, these are talking about your spiritual powers that you have, that you have to cultivate and grow. Because we have power. We have great power. Listen, we can cause tornadoes, earthquake. We can cause somebody's breath stopping. You know what I'm saying? We can literally, you know, take the ear from their lungs, stop the ear in their lungs. You know, and this isn't something that we would teach because, you know, well, everything is going to be made known and it's up to, because once upon a time we would never teach things like this because, you know, you don't want people to use it recklessly. But at the end of the day, you will be responsible for that which that you do. You know what I'm saying? You will be responsible. Okay? And so on that note, I'm just going to take my ass on. I know I probably rambled on. I was all over the place with this, but I just wanted to let people know, you know, the fuckery that, you know, these despots on the planet plan against the collective. And what we, the collective, can do to counteract that shit. You know what I'm saying? That which they sow, that they're going to reap into their own lives, in the lives of them and their motherfucking lineage. You know what I'm saying? And we are now going to use the power of ear, the power of water that you speak into, you know, the written word that you write on parchment paper, and you light it and you let it go. You know what I'm saying? You invoke the spirit of ear. And let me see, my old teacher. This was my old comedic teacher in Boston, Dr. Nateri Nelson, building the lighted temple, the Ka'aba. And let's see. Seeker, Sebek, S-E-B-E-K, Sebek, which deals with the third initiation that deals with Mercury, Gemini, and Virgo. Let me see. And I think I put my name in there. Yes, Priestess Aset, where I am at in Saturn in Capricorn, where I am. And this one, I'm in Samuel Herakuti. And Sebek, Raphael, Mercury, also, you know, because this is the tree of life that we have inside of us, you know, this is, and the right and the left, okay, this is Amen, This is Seeker. This is Harakuti. This is Sebek, Tahuti, Maat. You know what I'm saying? Het Heru. Heru in the middle and Aset. That is at 9. And this is Yesod. You know what I'm saying? And Geb, which is Earth. You know what I'm saying? And so we have the Kabbalistic system in our entire body. And at any given time, I'll do a video on activating different parts of that. You know, and everyone has a side, has a path. Yeah, that's the word. Everyone has a path on the tree of life that they vibrate on. I vibrate on, you know, the path of Capricorn and Mars. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm on the path of the left-hand side of the tree. You know? And this is, hold on, this goddamn menopause. Let's see. This is Bina and Gabura. Yes. Bina and Gabura. This is the left-hand path. I am on the 18th path of Cheth, and I'm on the path of Bina and Gabura, which is Saturn and Mars. Okay? And so, you know, I hope this video wasn't all over the place. I'm going to take my ass on, but I just wanted to do a video and let you all know the fuckery that is going on, you know, and that now that we know, now we can counteract some of this stuff. Because, see, it's going to be up to us that we are going to have to use our heka, our sacred utterance, you know what I'm saying, to, you know, to counteract a lot of this stuff. Because for too long, we have let these people just run amok on the planet and feel like they can just do whatever and do whatever to whomever. And like, there is no consequences. And no, bitches, there is consequences. And even if you do manage to kill one of us, somebody like myself, you've just unleashed an atomic bomb in the etheric realm. That bitch, I will be coming through the wind. You know what I'm saying? For you and your entire clan. You know what I'm saying? Because now I'm not in this physical body anymore. Now I am in the ether. Okay? And so let me just, I'm just going to pull a card and ask Great Mother Source, what is the message that you got for us? Let me blow on my cards. I'm only going to do one. Okay, Mother Source, Primordial Mothers, Ancestors, what is the message for the collective? What is a message for us now? Okay. You can't make this up. Aset, the sorceress. You can't make this up. What this is, this is about your inner magician. If this had been the Rider Waite deck, this would have been the magician. This is your magic. Let me hold it up for folks. Aset, the sorceress. I hope y'all can see this. This is Aset. This is my comedic mother, the sorceress. This is number one. And this is the very beginning. And what this means, this is dealing with fire, water, earth, air, spirit. This is the magician invoking the energy of the ether, the energy of fire, water, earth, air, ether, spirit. Okay? This is the magician. This is the first, the beginning of the magical system, the divine sorceress. The sorceress and the sorcerer. The witches and the wizards. The high priestesses and the high priest. The magician. This is the message to to cultivate and manifest your inner sorcerer, sorceress, and also to call and invoke the primordial mother Aset. To invoke Aset. What you want to do is you want to invoke her in all of your magical rituals because she rules over all of that. You know what I'm saying? And if I, you know, sometimes when I, you know, I have this and I do, and then I'll read the card on the bottom, and you can't make this up. Waret Hekau. This is the divine Heka. Your Heka magic. Heka. Heka magic. Waret Hekau. Heka magic. Now, isn't that what we was just talking about? And what are the odds that I, Priestess Aset Ra Amen, just randomly get my deck and say, you know, I'm going to pull some cards. I'm going to pull a card and see what source got for us. And so I did, you know, I just did one. And then I'm like, you know, sometimes I read the card on the bottom. And it's Waret Hekau. So, basically, what source is saying. And listen, I'm not being arrogant, but I am a high priestess of Aset. And I am an emissary of the primordial mother, the source, that I tap in and she gives me messages. And what are the odds? You see the cards? Aset, the sorceress, you understand? And Waret Heka, Hekau, Heka magic. Wasn't that what we was talking about? So this is what the message for you, the collective. This is the message for you. For you to tap into and to elevate your Heka magic, because we all have it. Your Heka magic. You understand? Your Heka, your divine Heka, your speech, your sacred utterance. And to call on the mother Aset, the divine sorceress, to invoke your inner sorcery, because we are all powerful. We are not powerless. We are, listen, we are powerful. That's why they fear us, because they know when we awaken spiritually, we ain't got to do nothing. We ain't never got to go out and protest and write no letters to Congress and do no shit like that. We can just sit our asses down and just speak a word. You understand? Now it's time for you to start to work on your divine Heka. And you do that through mantras. You know what I'm saying? You do that through mantras. And being that we are in the age of Aquarius, whose ancient ruler is Saturn, the Saturn mantra, Om Sham Shani Charaya Namaha. And you can do, also what I'm getting from Spirit, the Sun mantra, because we are people of the Sun and we are people of the Saturn. And so, you know, you do your mantras. You have to have a ritual. It's like a seed that you water and you nurture, that grows into a plant, that grows into a full-grown tree that bears fruit in due season. But you have to do the work. And so now, you see what came up? Aset. This is the mother of sorcery. And Heka, Waret Hekau, which is another mother of Heka magic that can be invoked to make your Heka. Okay? So on that note, I'm going to take my black ass on. So until next time, until The next time, same bat time, same bat channel. All right. All right.